Greetings, friends, and welcome to another edition of Moments in the Word. I am so happy that you could join me today. It has been a little while since we posted a devotional for you, but now that summer is here, we hope that we can get this back up and running and keep these coming to help encourage you in your walk with the Lord. Today I wanted to take just a couple of minutes to talk to you just about life in general and things that seem to be happening around us every single day. It seems like every time that I turn on my computer and get my news reports, there is some other tragedy that is happening around the world. This is not even something that is just affecting us here in the United States, but really all over the world. It seems as though our world is in a huge crisis, and there is turmoil on every hand. And that can really be awfully discouraging for those of us who would rather hear happy news than sad news. And just what really is a Christian supposed to do, or anyone for that matter, even those who don't yet have a relationship with Jesus Christ, what are we supposed to do with all of these tragic things that are happening around us? And what are we supposed to do when our hearts begin to be burdened and even fearful? You know, the Bible warns us that in the last days, the days that culminate up to the end of the world as we know it, before the return of Christ, that tragedies will increase, that natural disasters will increase, and that chaos will abound everywhere. As a matter of fact, the Bible tells us that it is going to get so bad that men's hearts will literally begin to fail them because of fear. Now, living in that kind of fear is torment, my friends, and it is something that really will literally drive you insane if you allow it. And I know that sometimes when we look around, just last night we heard of the shooting that happened up in South Carolina. Just a horrible, horrible event that happened when a gunman opened fire in a church, killing 9 people. And that makes us feel like, wow, we're not even safe inside of our houses of worship anymore. And if we can't be safe worshiping God in a place where His presence abide, where can we be safe? The reality is that we cannot let our minds think like that. Jesus told us to not be overcome with fear and to not let ourselves be wearied with much worry. And I know that that can sound a lot easier than it is to put into practice. Trust me, I am right there with you. And when I hear of these tragedies that happen around me, of course, naturally, one of my first thoughts goes directly to my children. I have 2 teenagers whom I love dearly, and my first thought always is, wow, what if that gunman would have come into my church last night? And what if that would have been my teenagers? And I know that the families that are involved in this shooting are thinking the exact same thing today. And our hearts go out to them and our prayers go out to them. And I wanted to take just a couple of moments to encourage you that as we see these things increasing, as we see the world just going further and further away from Christ, as the Bible warned us that it would do, that it is of utmost importance that we lock our faith into Christ and that we stand firm on His Word. He did promise us that He would be with us through every tragic situation in life. And sometimes that's really hard to understand when we look around and we think, well, where was He last night? These people loved Him, and where was God in the midst of all of that? And really the best answer that I have for you, an answer that sometimes doesn't seem to make sense and really doesn't even seem to bring a lot of comfort, is the fact that right now we are still a part of a fallen world, and there are still people in this world who still don't yet know Christ, who still are influenced by the demonic realm, who still listen to things in their mind and then begin to act out on those things that are contrary to how God would really have people treat each other. And while we are in this world, we will suffer the consequence of some of those actions. Being a Christian does not erase every bad thing from happening to us. But God really is with us through the midst of it all. And we can still see His hand in the middle of tragedy if we will just look for it. You know, the Bible gives us this final promise that as we see these things increasing, to lift up our head, to look up in faith, and to be watchful at every moment, because He promises to come and to rescue us soon. So I am encouraging you this week, just hold on to that promise. Don't let yourself be overcome with fear and worry or anxiety. Put your faith in Christ, knowing that He really does have it all under control. And if you will live according to the precepts of His word, He will be with you through every situation that you face. And very soon, He will be coming to rescue us and take us home to be with Him. If you don't yet know Jesus, and you don't yet have this promise in your life, please feel free to contact me. You can email me at dinaroseministries@yahoo.com, and I would be happy to talk to you a little bit further about these things and to help introduce you to the greatest man who ever lived, so that you can also have a relationship with Him and have peace in your heart. I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and we will see you in the next episode of Moments in the Word.